Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we are scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds for the Glory Welterweight Championship of the World. Let's meet the challenger. Fighting out of the black corner, a WKA World Champion who made his debut at Glory 22 France. His professional record, 64 wins with just 4 losses, 1 bout scored even, and 39 big career knockouts. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, 1.77 meters, and he weighed in at 168 and 1/2 pounds, 76.5 kilos. Fighting out of Cameroon by way of Bordeaux, France, here is Cedric the Best Doumbé. Here now is his opponent, fighting out of the white corner, a 4-time world champion, making his 4th defense of the Glory Belt. His professional record, impressive. 90 wins with just 11 losses, 46 of those wins by knockout, a perfect 12-0 in Glory. He stands 6 feet even, 1.83 meters, and he weighed in at 169 and 1/2 pounds, an even 77 kilos. Fighting tonight out of the Netherlands, he is the reigning and defending undisputed Glory Welterweight Champion of the World, Nicky the Natural Holmskin. Your referee in charge of this bout is Paul Nichols.
Okay, gentlemen, you understand the rules that you're fighting to. Protect yourself at all times, obey my commands at all times. Title fight, I expect you to fight like a title fight. Touch gloves if you want.
They do not touch gloves.
Judge.
Cedric Doumbé harassed Nicky Holmskin on social media. Holmskin actually blocked him on Twitter and told us, listen, Cedric Doumbé is acting like a lion with his mouth. I'll turn him into a kitten in the ring.
Well, all that talk is going to play out here. Let's see what Doumbé can do against Nicky.
Alistair, you said you expect Nicky to win. If you're Cedric Doumbé, what's your path to victory?
What's your path to victory? He's got to stay active. He's got to be able to fight backwards because Nicky has his slow pressure. He has his counter strikes. He has excellent boxing. Nicky's a tough guy. He's got cardio.
You can see how quick his hands are with those jabs that pop Doumbé straight backwards.
Yeah, Nicky's known for his pressure fighting, and he's going to sit there and look to really counterpunch and keep Doumbé against the ropes.
You mentioned Holmskin is a good boxer. He's undefeated in boxing, 11-0 with 8 knockouts. We saw him sparring online with Jaylion Love. Whoa, Holmskin, what that experience was like. He said he enjoyed it and said Love didn't come back to the gym the next day and spar with him again. There's a right hand from Doumbé that connects, but it's been all Holmskin here in round one, again with that jab.
And that shows his boxing experience, but Doumbé's doing a good job at countering back. And you can't be a standing target against Nicky. You've got to use your jab and kind of angle out and move. You've got to beat Nicky on angle. Do not stay in front of him.
Well, if Doumbé's strategy was to lose the first 2 rounds, he's doing a pretty good job so far. Another jab from Holmskin. Looks like George Foreman in there.
Yeah, Nicky up in his face every time.
Joe, it looks like Holmskin has the advantage with the hands. Who has the advantage with the kicks?
Well, Nicky does have good hands, but he hasn't been showcasing his low kicks as much. But if you look at his last few fights, against Congolo and Myrtle, he did a good job at attacking the inside leg. So I expect him to start using them as the rounds progress.
Cedric Doumbé coming off a victory over Myrtle Gruenhart. But he hasn't rested on his laurels since that win. He's fought 8 times in and around France since then, winning all his fights.
Nice block by Nicky there.
Outside low kick, a good one. And it's returned in kind from Doumbé. So a very fast round one, and Nicky Holst it off to a very good start.
Yeah, he's doing a good job at doing what he does best, controlling the center of the ring and constantly putting pressure. And he's finding a lot of success in that jab. He knows that Doumbé is trying to come in on the inside and try to fight on angle. So he just keeps landing that jab, and it's making it very difficult for Doumbé to get anything going.
What do you make of that start for your countryman, Allison?
Well, I see that Doumbé landed a little bit more strikes going on over the 45. I don't care if you make it all skin, though, but I'm a little bit biased.
Well, I think Doumbé is trying to be a little bit more active, but it's Nicky that's doing the most damage with those shots and landing the more clear shots.
Everyone can see those jabs landing, even at the very tip-top row here at the Coin Pilsner Arena.
Let's go.
Still to come tonight, of course, our main event, Rico versus Bonner. But a nice co-main for sure. The welterweight championship of the world on the line. And we asked Nicky if he'd ever had a fight that perhaps matched this environment. And the one he brought up, Joe, was the fight he had against you.
Yeah, Nicky and I had a fight of the year performance in Japan. And we had one of the most viewed fights in Glory history. It was our finals in Glory 13 Japan.
Nicky, of course, squeaked by you in that bout. A lot of fans asking if you'll ever come back, Joe. I know you suffer from concussions. What's the status of your career right now?
Well, right now I'm enjoying this job talking with you and Alistair. It seems to be safer on this side with the concussions.
I don't know. Alistair looks like he's ready to punch somebody. Be careful.
If anything, it's going after you.
Doumbé switching stances there for a moment.
Nice combination.
We haven't really seen Nicky throw his favorite shot, which is his left hook.
Alistair, you were right. Doumbé has landed more strikes. But the more telling strikes, the more visual strikes coming from Holskin.
Nice check. That hurts.
There's that jab again from the natural.
We saw Doumbé in the first round throw that jumping switch left knee. To beat Nicky, you're gonna have to throw something a little bit more unorthodox. Your traditional standing in front of the pocket throwing regular shots aren't gonna do it.
That was a nice combination, Doumbé.
Doumbé's starting to wake up here. Holskin needs to get busy. What a moment for both these men in their careers. A massive crowd, a title fight, a worldwide viewing audience, and you're on the same card as Bonner.
And he faked the hook and went right up for the uppercut.
Almost a bolo punch there from Cedric Doumbé, his best punch of the fight.
Clear counters by Doumbé, and he's also shown the ability to fight backwards.
Yeah, and he's putting good combinations together.
Hear that shot. Nice kick from Doumbé, who continues to switch from a southpaw to orthodox stance. You feel like Nicky perhaps is struggling to figure this guy out, Alistair?
Well, Nicky's putting pressure. He's forcing you to do something. And if you don't have any way to deal with that, you have a problem. But Doumbé is showing he's dealing with it just fine.
And he's taunting Nicky now. As Nicky missed that shot, he was looking to see where it went.
Tommy Lieutenant. Shots, low kicks, some nice combinations.
And then here comes that
making the right uppercut.
Those are those unorthodox shots that Dume needs to throw.
Again, the right uppercut, doing damage, winning the second round in my opinion.
I have to agree. That was definitely a better round for Dume, and I have this one round in. Alistair agrees.
If Nicky Holzke thought he might have an easy walk in the park with Cedric Dume, he was sadly mistaken. We've got a fight on our hands, and a pretty darn good one. Hopefully round three starts the same way round two ended. And Cedric Dume's game plan, at least the one he told us, Joe, was to start winning the fight in round three. He may have started in round two.
Let's see if he can keep this pace for the last three rounds.
9 minutes to go. Welterweight championship of the world. Nicky Holzke has never lost in glory. A 12-fight win streak.
But Nicky is tough and he has the ability to come back. He figures fighters out during the fight, and I expect him to come up with some sort of answer.
I agree, and he's very dangerous in the later rounds.
Outside low kick from Holzke.
And this is kind of a very similar fight that Nicky had with Myrtle.
And a very educated crowd here appreciates what Holzke is doing down low. Nice knee from Cedric Dume. Holzke continues to stalk him down. Throws a knee of his own, which Dume said didn't hit me.
If it did, it would have been night-night.
That was super close.
Pawing left hand there from Holzke. After winning his title, he's defended it four times. Most recently, to his countryman, Myrtle Grunhardt. A fight that Nicky Holzke won by unanimous decision.
Nicky turning it up here, putting even more pressure.
He hits up, guys.
Nicky's, Dume's movement's really good on the inside as Nicky's pressure. He just angles out and pivots out, which is making it very difficult for Nicky to counterpunch.
Question now becomes, can Dume keep this up?
Exchange outside low kicks. Both have landed 11 head punches. Dume, though, has been more active. We didn't see this much activity against Myrtle Grunhardt. He was more selective with his punches, but tonight, letting them fly.
Yeah, he wasn't too happy with his performance against Grunhardt, but he did have an awesome glory debut against Johan Kongola, which was a really close fight that could have gone either way.
Nicky Holzke with a record of 90-11, 46 wins by knockout. Dume 64-4-1, 39 knockouts.
Oh, that right landed. Dume seems very relaxed. It seems like he's fighting a game he's well prepared for.
He's having fun.
This totally reminds me of Nicky's fights with Grunhardt. Grunhardt was really doing good job fighting on the outside and being active.
Dume says that hit my hand. That hit his forearm. A close round three here.
Good action.
Final 10 seconds. Just missing.
This is an exciting fight.
Are those little taunts getting to Nicky? Making him want to open up? Who knows?
I've always wondered what those have an effect on the judges as well. Do they see that and appreciate that he's so relaxed? Or do they see it as overcome?
It must have, because it's dominance. He's making his opponent miss. Never looks good.
Yeah, you saw that a lot with Mayweather. But here's that missed kick by Nicky. And Dube showing him that he missed. And it was blocked off the glove. Dube's been really slick with his head movement, even trying to get inside and exiting, making it really hard for Nicky to find his counter left hook.
And I think Dume has shown us three of the things he claims to be on his website tonight. He's a boxer, a comedian, and an actor so far.
Alistair, how do you have round three?
Go!
No, Nicky's my boy, but he needs to do something. He needs to change it up.
Go!
I gotta agree, it's a very close round, but it's that activity of Dume that seems to be stealing it.
So but according to our unofficial judges, Alistair Overeem and Joseph Baltellini, it's 2-1 for the challenger, Cedric Doumbé. Round four. Spinning back fist
Break.
Just missed.
Great.
But it's round
Let
four
go.
And five.
Keep
that
head up.
Nicky really
Pink.
Shines.
Fight.
He conserves his energy, and you're going to see him really pick it up in the fourth and fifth round. These are the championship rounds. Doumbé said that Nicky wants to try and destroy my legs in the first two rounds. I won't let him do that. I'll destroy his. And you can see the redness.
Hook and uppercut.
The redness on Nicky Holsken's left leg. And that left hand connects.
And that's that counter hook that made Nicky so successful. And a lot of guys, if you fight Nicky, you know that's one of his most dangerous shots. But I'm loving those uppercut that Doumbé's throwing because Nicky stands his ground with a nice high shield, so Doumbé is angling out and throwing uppercuts.
Doumbé with a parting shot there. Like you said, Alistair, it seems like Nicky needs to be more active.
Yeah, that's the thing I don't like about Nicky. He's allowing his opponent to be more active to start first.
And he waits a little too long to counterpunch. There's that jab that Nicky had in the first round. He's starting to use it again.
And Doumbé has thrown 60 more strikes than Holsken.
Some good low kicks by Holsken.
This fight has flown by. Just 90 seconds left in round four.
And oh, almost.
And another one. The right hand.
And it's that counter left hook again for Nicky. Doumbé's got to be careful. Don't get too confident. Stick to his fight.
A nervous buzz here in the Coin Pilsner Arena as these fans perhaps sense that Doumbé is doing enough to win this fight. Oh, and another uppercut from Doumbé.
Doumbé's fighting the right fight.
It's all going right for the Frenchman.
And he's relaxed. That's something that must frustrate Nicky. Fighting a guy, you're putting pressure, but he's relaxed. He's relaxed and he's throwing.
And Doumbé's doing a good job on transitions. He's catching Nicky as he's coming in and catching him on the exit.
30 seconds left here for Holsken to turn it around. This is Holsken's fifth straight five-round fight. Doumbé, his first. But he looks like the veteran right now.
Looks like there's some blood coming down the nose of Nicky.
Round four, gentlemen. What did you see?
Doumbé. Unfortunately, because Nicky's my boy, but Doumbé's doing more. He's able to land kicks, land punches. He's got that fade hook that switches into an uppercut. He's doing more damage, and body language is saying it, right? He's winning the fight.
Yeah, Nicky isn't doing enough. He did land some good shots with that counter left hook, some good low kicks and knees.
That knee.
But in my opinion, he needs to be a little bit more active. And Doumbé just continually answers. Nicky might land a single, but Doumbé's coming back with 3-4 shots after that. Where that's what Nicky needs to do. If he's gonna land one shot, follow up after.
No panic in the corner right now for Nicky Holsken. It seems like business as usual as Robin van Roosmalen, another Dutch fighter, another Dutch champion, is looking on, perhaps seeing his countrymen, seeing his title slip away.
Fight!
Round five, it all comes down to this. Nicky Holsken, Cedric Doumbé, welterweight championship of the world.
Nicky needs to turn it up in this round, though. He needs to get a knockdown. A lot of damage done. He needs to do something.
Yeah, he's not being active enough. That's what it comes down to, is Doumbé being more active, using his footwork and his angles, and constantly attacking and exiting. And as Doumbé exits, he throws something because he knows Nicky's going to counter.
According to our fight metric statistics, while Doumbé has been much more active, Holsken has been more accurate, both with 25 strikes landed. Oh, that nice. nice inside low kick from Holskin.
But looking at the total strikes, it has Holskin landing 56 and Doumbé 98 in the total fight.
Time is not Holskin's friend right now.
That was a good right hand by Holskin.
Alistair said earlier that Nicky knows how to figure his opponents out. Has he figured Doumbé out?
He has not yet. He has not yet, unfortunately, but he's got to do it quick because 90 seconds left in the final round.
Don't count Nicky out, though, let me tell you. My fight with Nicky went down right to the final second.
Keep in mind there are five judges tonight, not the normal three. Perhaps that could play some sort of role. A sweep, so no knockdown for Doumbé.
Doumbé's definitely slowed down though. I don't think he should close too much.
Eats a left hand coming in, does Doumbé. The crowd's starting to rise up again.
I'm telling you, this is going to be a tough 45 seconds for Doumbé.
The jab has worked all night for Nicky Holskin when he throws it.
The jab's also working well for Doumbé.
Outside of round number one, it's hard to give a definitive round for Holskin since then, including this fifth round.
I think he's doing more damage this round. I would definitely give him this
uppercut by Holskin.
Quick! A knockdown would sure come in handy for the champion, but I don't think he's going to get it. Just seconds left. Won the welterweight championship. Doumbé's corner extremely excited and optimistic that their fighter has done enough. Not nearly as joy in Nicky Holskin's corner.
Yeah, it was Nicky starting really strong, establishing that jab. In round two, it was Doumbé started really to pick up his combination, and it's a sneaky uppercut, and it continued in round three. Although Doumbé took some shots, but Nicky kept coming back, coming forward, punching and kicking at good angles and was a lot more active. The fifth round was a better round for Nicky. Doumbé seemed to slightly slow down, and I gave that last round to Nicky. It was a very close round, though.
As we look at the strikes by round, you can see that Doumbé outstruck Nicky Holskin 4-1, including the first round, Alistair.
True. This is a hard one to predict. I thought Doumbé was a little more active. He had showed the ability to fight backwards. He outstruck Nicky Holskin. Nicky's my boy. I don't know for this one.
Cedric Doumbé is wearing a t-shirt right now that says, "End of Nicky." Will we see the end of Nicky's title reign tonight? We're still waiting for the decision. They're tabulating the scores. Alistair feels that Doumbé did enough. What say you, Joe?
Well, I'm going to give it 3-2 to Doumbé.
Did the best, as he's known. Prove it here tonight in Oberhausen. I see Tim Hughes, our ring announcer, stepping back onto the canvas. Scorecards in hand. Let's send it to him now to find out who the welterweight champion will be.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five championship rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard. Here are the totals. They score this bout 48-47, Doumbé. 48-47, Holskin. 48-47, 48-47, and 48-46, all for your winner by split decision. And new glory welterweight champion of the world, Cedric Doumbé. the belt, our head of talent operations, Core Hammers, and our Glory Sports International Director, Paul Karger.
Jubilation from Dubé's corner as they have knocked off Nikki the Natural Holskin.
And that was an incredible performance by Dubé, really using that movement and that angles and really shut down Nikki's counterpunch and really kept active and won him this fight.